Om Sri Sai Ram, Prashanti Sandesh. Welcome to Sai Pearls of Wisdom. In this brief talk, I would like to speak on a theme that Baba is the King of Kings. He is the King of Kings. This statement is made on the basis of my personal observations. Let me tell you one after another. A Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of India came for Bhagavan's Darshan to Kodaikanal, and that gentleman requested me to inform Swami that he is waiting for his Darshan. When I went inside and informed Swami, Bhagavan said, "He is not special. Let him wait. He has no horns, H-O-R-N-S. So let him wait." That's what Bhagavan said. This was my first experience with Swami, to come to know that position does not matter anything to Bhagavan. My second experience in Brindavan is this. A union minister belonging to Rajasthan came for Bhagavan's Darshan. By that time, Swami retired already. Morning Darshan was over. Interviews were over. Swami retired. This union minister, with a battalion of cabinet ministers and district level, state level officers, he arrived there, Brindavan. And the union minister requested Sri Rama Brahmam, the then caretaker of Brindavan, "Sir, would you please inform Swami that I have come here? I am waiting for his darshan." Rama Brahmam said, "When once he retired, no one can dare to disturb him. No one can go there and inform him." "I am sorry," he said. The union minister waited and waited and left. The moment he left, Swami came down. "I was waiting there." This is the statement Swami made. Let him be any man of any stature. They have to wait for me. I am not going to wait for anybody. And I also remember another instance at Madras. The then governor of Tamil Nadu, who happened to be a long-time devotee of Bhagavan, somehow, due to the reasons not known to us, he was made to wait for his darshan for about 3 days. 3 days. I'm a witness to that. He spoke to him on the fourth day. That is the level of Bhagavan. I also remember Bhagavan giving a talk in the Purnachandra auditorium. It was attended by S.B. Chavan, the then union minister in charge of rural development program. Swami, in his discourse, said openly, "How is the rural development going on in India? The officers, IAS officers, the ministers sit there in air-conditioned offices, discuss and declare and decide. They don't visit any village at all. They have no idea of village problems and village life or rural ambience. Things are decided there." These statements made by Bhagavan in front of the union minister, Purnachandra auditorium then was fully packed. Swami is the King of Kings. He is not afraid of anything, of anybody. I also remember another instance, the then President of India, Sri Venkatraman happened to visit Prasanthalayam. While he was there seated, and the whole of the stadium was fully packed, there Swami made a statement. Why not the union government take up this activity of offering education totally free of cost? Why should they charge like that? Making a market of education and health is very cheap. Why can't you do it? That's what Swami said to the President of India straight away. Bhagavan is King of Kings. I also remember another instance, the then Prime Minister of this country, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, made a statement in Bangalore. Vajpayee is a long-standing devotee of Bhagavan for decades. Right from the beginning of his political career, he is really remained very, very loyal to Bhagavan. That year, he visited Swami and participated in Nagar Sankirtan also, along with boys. He joined that procession. In the evening, while giving a speech, Vajpayee made a statement. He said, Swami, this kind of summer course is very much required for all the parliamentarians, for all the legislators in this country. I request you to organize such a course in Vijnan Bhavan, there in Delhi. That was his request. You can just imagine the King of Kings, Bhagavan, Sri Sat Sai Baba. I also remember same Vajpayee telling on the day of the inauguration of the super speciality hospital in Bangalore. He said, the construction of the hospital is possible of such a magnitude and dimension within a record time by Bhagavan Baba only. If government is to take up that activity, it would take minimum 10 years. Just imagine that Prime Minister openly declaring on the dais, King of Kings, Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. All of you must have noted when the then President of India, Abdul Kalam, visited Prasanthalayam. There in the Kulwant Hall, he came close to Swami and sat on the ground. On the ground, though a separate chair is kept for him. He just sat on the ground, cross-legged in front of Bhagavan. Bhagavan is the King of Kings. Apart from that, you may be surprised to know that Abdul Kalam met many, many devotees asking his security to keep away from him, telling that he came here as a devotee, not as the President of India. King of Kings, Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. It's also on record that President Croxi, President of Italy, happened to be here. After morning session, where did we find Croxi? We find Croxi there outside Prasanthalayam, buying some lockets and vibhuti packets from shops outside Prasanthalayam, President of Italy. Imagine that. I also would like to tell you another instance of the visit of Session, the Chief Election Commissioner of India. Prior to his occupation in that capacity, that post was not at all known in this country. It was just a post held by people, that's all. But this man Session made it great and unique. He made all chief ministers, including Prime Minister Indira Gandhi, accountable to him as the Chief Election Commissioner. Swami had been to Bangalore and visited Chaudhaya Memorial Hall in Bangalore. That was attended by many people of eminence from political circles. Veerappa Moili was the Chief Minister of Karnataka. Jafar Sharif was the Union Minister of Railways. They were all there on the dais. And Session was yet to arrive to the auditorium. When Session was arriving, there was thunderous, resounding applause in the auditorium. Because he was very, very famous, very popular, and his achievements have been made very well known to the public. So when he was just getting into the auditorium, what a kind of tumultuous welcome he had, the wonderful reception he had, and youth jumping in joy, dancing, welcoming Session the Great. That gentleman came slowly, gently, majestically, and climbed the staircase, came close to Swami on the dais. There's a very big garland, huge garland, brought by two or three Sevadal, because very huge garland. They were about to garland Session. You know what he did? He refused to be garlanded. He collected with both of his hands the garland, and he sat squatted on the ground and started separating the flowers from the garden, from the garland, and started worshipping the feet of Bhagavan Sri Sat Sai Baba. And in his speech he said, all of you have been appreciating me, all of you have been conveying your compliments to me, all of you have been appreciating my courage. But I tell you, the source of all these things is Bhagavan Baba. I draw strength from his lotus feet. He is my strength. That made me speak with guts and courage. And he also said in his talk, it was Prahlada, very near that Narasimha, God who appeared in lion and human form. Prahlada was fearless, smiling, singing Narayana, Narayana. Whereas the father of Prahlada, Hiranyakasipu, the demon king, he was shivering. Why? Prahlada has the support of the divine. Prahlada was so strong in his spirit because Bhagavan is by his side. Whereas Hiranyakasipu had no guts. He was shivering. The same thing is said by Session. When once I started relying on Bhagavan, I'm quite courageous. I was never timid. And therefore I could pronounce my judgment openly, unbiased. Baba is King of Kings. There's no doubt about it. There's no doubt about it. I also remember the Prime Minister of Nepal visited We visited Prashantralayam and he was greeted by Bhagavan, welcomed him, spoke to him. And he came to the interview room, bending almost, and came there, Sairam. So humble and simple in front of him. I also remember the President and the Prime Minister of Sri Lanka visiting Bhagavan. They were very, very simple, humble in front of Bhagavan. What I want to impress upon you, my friends, all here are devotees. We don't have anything special with us. However, the positions held in the government naturally demand some protocol and special reception and courtesies extended to them. They are all extended, all formalities fulfilled. But Swami does not give any preference to them as individuals. In fact, in one of the meetings he said, many people of eminence of position come to me. I grant them interviews. What is that I tell them? To take care of people, to serve the society, so that they would feel proud of their tenure of office, having done something good to the community. Therefore, the title of the talk is King of Kings. Thank you very much for your time. We'll meet again. Sai Ram.